Love is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to arise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
Champion!
Come on in, Bruce.
Come on, Bruce.
Hello,
have a seat.
Bruce.
Have a seat.
No, I'd rather stand.
You should have been there, Madam Su. Would you believe this guy said he would defeat Mr. Kimura in less than 1 minute?
Oh, really?
And then later on it became 30 seconds.
Did you manage to win it?
He sure did. In 11 seconds.
Hey, come on. When I decided to set a time to defeat him, I wasn't even sure I'd pull it off.
Really? Mm-hmm. Why'd you do it in the first place?
I'm not sure what came over me then. When I heard his students insulting the Chinese, they offended us all. So I had to hit back. But that was kind of stupid now that I think about it. If I wasn't able to defeat the guy in 30 seconds, then I'd have to leave Seattle. Thank goodness he went down.
Hey, you were great.
Yeah.
Hey, I've been in the US for a long time now, but I've never been so proud to be Chinese as I did when you told them off. He told them, Kimura, tell your students that my people are respectable.
See? Great impression.
Come, sit down, sit down.
Now, careful.
Hey,
this is
I'll have to get in touch with James to tell him about this and call some journalists. His name will just have to be in every newspaper around here, right?
Nobody out there is ever going to take karate seriously after this. It's all because of that insignificant Chinese brat.
Probably pulled the trigger on the master without his knowing. If it didn't, how would have he even managed to defeat Mr. Kimura in just a span of 11 seconds? That boy cheated, I'm telling you, Yutian.
If he did, then he got away with it.
What's the matter with you people? Don't you have the grace to accept defeat instead of behaving like sore losers? Do you really think karate is just all about winning a game?
Worked so hard to get where we are. And in just one night, everything we've established for years has turned to dust. All because of some Chinese brat.
So what do you want?
If it won't be such a bother, Mr. Lee, I would like to compare karate again with kung fu.
What else is there to compare? I already defeated you.
I wish to learn from a master.
Sorry, I'm not a master. I'm just a simple Chinese student who practices a native martial art. And I won't be intimidated by anyone who's just too full of themselves. I have to get to work, or I might lose my job. I'll see you around sometime.
Good
morning, sir.
Hey there, Bruce.
The usual deliveries?
Yeah, and hey, you were great last night.
Oh, you were there. Thank you, sir.
Can I get an autograph from you?
Well, I'm kind of in a hurry, sir. After I deliver these, I still have to go to school, so I gotta hurry. Maybe next time.
Sure.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Kid. You take care.
You too. Goodbye.
Bye.
They've humiliated us! I'm going to kill that Chinese bastard! I swear I'm gonna kill him!
You know what? Your outbursts make you no different from a street thug, as men of martial arts. We uphold our honor by accepting our defeat with dignity, not by threats.
I can't. We just can't accept defeat!
Losing in that match was humiliating enough. We must not go any lower. So don't hurt him!
Master Kimura, where are you going?
Here's the door key. I'm giving it to you, Yutian. Lock up after you're done here.
All right, Master.
Master Yutian, why is Master Kimura being so mysterious?
Maybe he's going to hunt down that Chinese punk himself.
Then what are we waiting for? Let's go and follow him. He can't deal with that jerk all by himself. He needs all the help he can get.
Shut up! Sit down! Master Kimura is capable of dealing with his problems himself. If he wants to be left alone, then that's what we're going to do. If we went to help him, it would only humiliate him.
It's all right. Come in.
Master Bruce Lee.
Huh. It's you again. I guess they never told you about it. But just so you know, I don't do fights unless it's a public competition. And I'm not into street fights. So you'd better go.
I'm not here to fight.
Then tell me what else you're here for.
I've come to learn from you.
Stop being absurd.
Mr. Lee, I didn't come here to cause any trouble, but to learn from you. If you would be kind enough to teach me.
I thought you guys said karate is the best martial art in the world.
Mr. Lee, I once won a match with someone who claims he was a Chinese martial arts master. When I first saw him move, my first impression was that the Chinese martial arts was too inferior. It looks mysterious. But still, it was no different from the fancy acrobatic stunts you would see in a circus act. I defeated him very easily. That was why I believed that the Japanese martial arts, judo and karate, are the best in the world. So when you claimed that they were mere offshoots of the Chinese kung fu, I got insulted. I had to prove you were wrong. And then I got defeated, and by a young student like yourself. So I would be deeply honored if you taught me more about Kung Fu.
You can learn that from books. Kung Fu, also called Chinese boxing, has existed for over 5,000 years. It's also recognized as the origin of the Japanese judo and karate. Do your research!
That's not what I meant. When I said I want to learn more about Kung Fu, I was hoping you teach me. So please instruct me.
Now level with me here. Are you playing the cheap beggar role on me?
Cheap beggar role? Please explain.
Hey, you tell me. Look, I defeated you, right? So you're supposed to want to defeat me right now. But no, you want to be my student. No wonder your martial arts never made any progress.
Can you explain further, Master?
Here's another case. I once defeated a British schoolmate named Blair in Hong Kong. And right after his defeat, he decided to be my friend. That was when I learned about the term playing the cheap beggar role. And I realized that wherever I go, there will always be cheap beggars around. Is that clear enough?
Master Bruce, at least please give me a few basic lessons.
You know, you guys are really persistent. All right, I'll show you a few moves. I guess there's no harm in that. But we're not sparring, you hear?
Thank you.
All right, Mr. Kimura. You're ready.
Come on. It's like a fight.
Come on.
Beat him up, man! Come on, beat him up! Come on, beat him up! Whoa!
Don't worry, I won't hurt you. Simple practice. Come on, fight. Continue.
Beat him! Come on, you can do it! Right! Come on, show him what you got! Do it, do it, do it! Come on!
Again,
show what you got! Come on! Get up!
I learned something.
What have you learned?
You're swift. Your punches and moves are twice fast.
That's not all. You should also learn how to predict your opponent's next move.
So that's why you were able to avoid and counterattack all my moves. Any attack would be pointless then, no matter how strong.
Hey, listen, there's no mystery in Kung Fu. It's just plain common sense.
So you mean you learned all those techniques from training?
The first thing I learned when I decided to learn about Kung Fu was to make use of all your skills thoroughly. To do that, I had to learn two things. First, whenever you throw a punch, you always have to strike your target rapidly and hard like a kick. Like that. Got it? Second, you must stretch your two legs the way you would stretch both of your arms. Will you get up?
This take me as your apprentice.
Hey, get up from there.
Will you have me then?
Aren't you a bit too old to be my apprentice?
I've no problem with that. For so many years, I have dedicated my life to karate. But now all I want is to learn your martial art by being your apprentice. If you'll have me.
But you're Japanese.
Martial arts should have no national boundaries.
I refuse. We can exchange skills, but you cannot be a lowly apprentice.
To yourself. I saw how you knelt, Master, and how you pleaded with that Chinese kid right in front of all those stupid street punks. Nobody in their right mind will ever trust you as a leader. You ruined yourself. You betrayed us in favor of that Chinese. Why, Master? Huh? Why did you betray us? How could you do this to us?
This kung fu is a lot more effective than the karate. When we fought, my chance of winning was slim.
We could have invited a better karate expert over to do that. To get even for us. Why did you have to kneel in front of him? Huh? Why did you do that?
Only from humility and learning from others can we improve ourselves. I regard him as my teacher.
Is that what you want? You've promoted him to be your master? And learned Chinese Kung Fu? Is that what you want?
Yes, it's what I want.
If you should pursue this any further, you will be dismissed from your position in karate.
Yutian, you're drunk. So I suggest you go home. You're in no position to judge me. If you feel too insulted by what I've done, then take your students and go.
You're an insult. You've shamed our people.
Offered kung fu lessons to us.
Yeah, come on.
Me? Yeah, you've got good grades, so you don't have to spend all your time studying.
Yes, I mean, if you're willing, then you don't have to do the food and paper deliveries.
Listen, guys, I need to earn a living. I need to prepare for college, so I have to work.
You can earn more by teaching us.
I'm sorry, but I couldn't do that. I'll see ya.
Hey, Bruce, come on.
Then fine. All right, here's the deal. If you really want to practice kung fu, then you'll have to start training your feet. In a day, I'll always run about 10 kilometers. Now, if you can do that, then that's great. I can teach you. Sounds good?
So you want us to run 10 kilometers a day?
Come on, man. Cut us a little slack.
If that's the case, you guys are better off learning karate.
Why would you even want to learn karate after you've beaten all of them?
Because you all want to have things the easy way. So I figured you'd rather learn karate. Come on, let's go.
Well, let's do this thing. If we can do 10 kilometers, let's try it.
Let's
go. We can do it, yeah.
Guys were cut out for kung fu.
Can't do this.
Great, everybody's giving up then.
Well, I still haven't given up.
Well, at least those guys knew when to give up. Well, you don't.
And is that bad?
I'm not sure yet.
Mr. Lee, I will follow you wherever you go for that apprenticeship. And I'm not going to stop until you take me in.
Look, I told you already. I'd never have you as an apprentice. You're Japanese, and you've been practicing karate for so many years.
Mr. Lee, if you don't have me as your apprentice, then you'll never reach your goal.
And just what would that goal be?
Your goal is to make Chinese Kung Fu the best martial arts in the world, right?
Yeah, so what?
Then you'll have to learn from our judo and karate.
Why would I have to do that?
Just for simple management. Most of the major cities in the U.S. have their own karate and judo dojos. They even have teams in school, your school being one of them. These things only prove how established karate has become around here. It has come a long way, from the first judo and karate dojos that were first introduced in some states, so that's something you can do. And if I may suggest, be open to students who want to learn. Having me just won't be enough. Then you can make the Chinese Kung Fu popular around the world.
Right. To be honest, I never really figured it that way. Anyway, I gotta go do my deliveries. Take care. Hey, one more thing. Starting tomorrow, don't ever come here again.
That's my problem.
Then I'll change my route. You'll never see me here again.
Then that's your problem.
You... do what you want. So, are you dumb or something?
No matter what you say to me, my mind is already set on one thing, which is to be your apprentice. I want to learn Kung Fu.
Look, Kimura, what's the point in that? You've made karate your way of life for years. Why on earth will you think of shifting to Kung Fu now? I really don't understand you.
I know you don't. I don't understand myself either. I suppose I needed to find something to keep me going by fighting my way around the world.
Sounds like you have really been through a lot.
Would it be all right if I invited you to my tea house?
All right. So you're saying when I defeated you back then, it really blew your mind?
It sure did. Please.
Kind of like how Hiroshima and Nagasaki must have felt when the A-bombs fell on them, right?
I guess you could say that.
I just knew it. I'm sure you guys hated the Americans after they did that. So why on earth are you staying in the U.S.?
My parents were immigrants here before the war. I was born in a small town in the state of Washington back then. When World War II broke out after Japan's attack on Pearl Harbor, everyone here had very strong anti-Japanese sentiments. And naturally, they zoned in on every Japanese immigrant living here. When I went to school then, I would always get beaten up. So my parents decided it was best I stayed home. Later, all Japanese immigrants were assigned to settle in camps where we stayed for 5 years. 5 years. It was a long wait for us.
I can imagine.
Only when the war was over did they decide to release us from the camp. And even if they won the war, the Americans still remained hostile towards us. We had lost everything during the war, and times were hard. Right after we left the camp, I tried several times applying for a job. They'd throw me out when they learned that I'm of Japanese descent. Finally, I decided to give that up. I became a street peddler. I saved whatever money I could until I was finally able to put up this tea house.
Well, you did all right. This is cool.
Actually, back then, this was my dream. It had saved me from giving up then. You know, Mr. Lee, I used to be depressed and hopeless. I wanted my life to be over back then. I was saved by this tea house and karate.
So you just learned karate during that time?
Yes. Karate had given me back my life. It brought back my confidence. This tea house has always been frequented by the best karate artists. But now that I have a young master in kung fu, which is about the best style of martial arts I'll ever see in this lifetime, I fulfilled my dream. Kung fu isn't just a form of self-defense. It also reflects your attitude towards life. Martial arts should not only inspire courage, it should help you become a better person, right? So you're right. It's like an A-bomb blowing in my head. So I'm begging you, let me be your apprentice. Teach me the ways of kung fu. It's the only way my life will have meaning.
You're right. You didn't have it easy either. I just can't believe that a Japanese guy like you is going to make me eat my words.
Oh, did I? Can you explain how?
Mr. Kimura, I'm a man of my word. And I said I'd never make you my apprentice. The thing is, after what you told me today... All right, then. I take back what I said.
Thank you, Master Bruce.
Will you quit that? Hmm? Yung Jun Chuan gives importance to the center line. So whether you're attacking or defending, always hit center. Try it. Fast block and snap punch. Right at the center. If your punch doesn't reach your opponent, extend it with the use of your body. Okay? Now you try it. Come on. Block. Give your counterattack. Punch in the center line. Fantastic. Now remember, when you're doing your blocks, you have to do it sideways, like this. To avoid your opponent's force. Then hit him. Remember that.
I will.
Next lesson.
Time with me. From now on, you may consider this place as your own. Feel free to drop by anytime. You know, Master, you don't have to stay in that place you have. You can always stay here if you wish.
And sit cross-legged here? I'm not used to that.
All right. Sit down, Sensei.
I appreciate the thought, sir. Actually, we're both learning from all this. You've taught me a lot about the essence of Japanese martial arts.
No, Master. You're my teacher. I'm just a student.
You're still a master in Japanese karate. Now look, just stop calling me master. I'm not a kung fu master. I want to learn karate from you, so I should call you master.
But compared to what you've taught me, it would be pointless to teach you karate now. I really like the Yong Chun Chuan. I've read a lot of books that show various styles of kung fu. But still, I found your Yong Chun Chuan special. A lot of your moves, I found in the books. Sometimes I'd remember them. Then I'd completely forget one move.
Mr. Kimura, most of the time, I like to mix Chinese and Western dishes.
Oh.
What I'm saying is, I improvise some of the moves I've learned. Some of those moves actually came from other sources.
So that's it. That's incredible. You know, you never cease to amaze me. I noticed that your Yong Chun Chuan do have moves like... Well, I recognize the skips from boxing and a little of cha-cha as well. That was why I couldn't find any moves in any of the books. About the style, I mean. Adding some cha-cha moves is a great idea. Even the way a punch is different from how they explained it in books about Yong Chun Chuan. And you know, some kicks you taught are totally different from Yong Chun Chuan's. Or was it Hong Chuan? Or maybe Nan Chuan? Okay, I'm really
confused. You sure love to ruminate, you know that?
I'll take it as a compliment. Anyway, Mr. Lee, have you ever dreamed of opening a Yong Chun Chuan house in here?
Yes, of course I have. It's not going to be easy, but I really wish that someday we can have a kung fu house here, and that it will be as popular as the Japanese martial arts dojos around here and all over.
Remember your own native proverb. A 1,000 miles journey always begins with a single step.
Yeah, well, the first step is not an easy thing to take.
What if I helped you do it?
Help me start a kung fu house?
Do you think this will be enough?
You'd convert this to a kung fu house. Are you mad? You lose your income. Let's talk later. I gotta study for the college entrance test.
Oh, sure. Good luck. I hope you do well. I'll walk you to the door, Sensei.
Your chance to arise your way. Let your spirit be brave. Always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
I'm sorry. Are you okay? Can you get
up? Why'd you have to hit me?
I'm sorry. It's just my reflex reaction when somebody taps me from behind. Are you all right?
Don't touch me.
Are you sure?
Will you take your hands off of me, you gorilla?
Hey, come on. I really didn't mean it. Is there something I can do to make you feel better? Quit it.
So why did you hit me then?
It wasn't intentional. It was a reflex. Whenever someone sneaks up on me, my hand would hit that person automatically and unknowingly. If you're someone who's been practicing martial arts for so long, your arms and legs would tend to do that. They defend you subconsciously.
Is that a fact?
Mm-hmm. It's actually an instinctive reaction.
Or maybe you're just going bananas.
Yeah, why'd you say that?
Because you should be looking at the college test results on the bulletin board instead of howling out here like some gorilla.
You know what? I'm gonna tell you something.
What?
I'm feeling nervous about it, so I was avoiding to take a look. I'm afraid I might have flunked that college entrance test, actually.
Hey, you have nothing to be afraid of. It's just a college entrance exam.
Don't you get it, Alana? I'm dying to go to college, as I was a kid. Even my parents are expecting me to go to college, you know?
Congratulations. You made it.
I passed? I don't believe you.
Here, that's your letter of admission to the school.
You mean it's not April Fool's Day today?
April Fool's been over since last month.
So I got in?
That's right. It only proves you passed.
Yes! I can't believe I'm going to college.
Yeah. Anyway, aren't you going to ask me if I made it or not?
Hey, you're one of the top notchers, so I'm sure you made it. You know already.
Well, I made it to the same university.
Really?
Yeah.
I haven't chosen a course yet. What about you?
Business administration.
Business administration? I don't know if I can handle that course. All right, I'm in. As long as you're doing my homework.
Your homework?
Mm-hmm.
We'll see about that.
Don't you like doing my homework anymore?
Yeah, if...
You mean... You won't do it?
Yeah, of course. I'd be glad to do whatever you want. But right now... My father doesn't want me to stay in the U.S. anymore. So I might have to go back to the Philippines. Or stay in the U.K. to study.
Oh. Good luck then.
You can count on it. The school year is going to be very promising. I'm sure he'll adjust in no time. Yes, of course. Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on a moment. Please come in. Oh, I think it must be Bruce Lee who just came into my office, Miss Shu. All right, all right. We'll talk about it later. Thank you, Miss Shu. Well, hello. You must be Bruce Lee.
Yes, sir, that's me. You must be Professor Keen.
Yes, I am. The decrepit old man that everybody calls Professor Keen. You can just call me Mr. Keen. Welcome to our university.
Thank you, sir. Was that Miss Shu you were talking to?
Yes, she told me a lot about you. She told me that you were an exceptionally bright student in your school. And at the same time, you had to do odd jobs to pay for your education and to make a living. I find this all very inspiring. That's why we'd like to provide you a bright future. But then I've been told that you haven't chosen a course yet, so we'd like to help you out.
That's right, sir. I'm really confused.
You've raised a tough question for a decrepit old man like me to answer. But the best person to ask about your future is yourself. You can't rely on other people's suggestions, so tell me, what do you like?
Well, actually, I like a lot of things, so I don't know where to start.
Okay, young man, just try to relax while we analyze what you really want for yourself. Please sit down. So would you like to study a course that would be more financially fulfilling? Or would you choose a course that will give you inner peace? You see that there are two types of choices, with two different results. So you better ask yourself which matters more to you. Is it the material or the spiritual gain that you want? Write down the pros and the cons of these choices. Whatever you choose will determine the person you become. All right, so tell me, do you have a personal dream?
Yes, sir, I do.
Oh, would you like to tell me?
Actually, sir, I want to be a respected martial artist in the U.S. Sorry if that sounded too arrogant, sir. I guess I was being too presumptuous to say that so openly here.
No, of course not. It's just this is the first time I've ever heard a student mention that kind of dream. But you have every right to fulfill that dream. Talking about it doesn't make you presumptuous or arrogant. What I heard from you was not arrogance, but determination. Is there something more you want to say?
Actually, sir, I am still feeling confused about what to major in to fulfill my dream. I want to find something that can help me answer all my questions in life.
Oh, well, in that case, why do you still have to feel confused when you've already solved your problem? You already know your answer.
I do? Why didn't I see it?
You're too busy looking somewhere else.
What is it, then?
Philosophy.
I never even thought about studying philosophy.
Ah, Bruce. Philosophy is the search of truth by deep thinkers of all times. Only philosophy will help you find the answer to all the questions you've always wondered about. It'll help you fulfill your dream.
Then, Mr. Keen, I'm going to major in philosophy.
Good. You've made the right choice, Bruce. Come sit
Thank
with
you,
me.
Sir.
Let's sit over here. It's a pity we don't have anything to drink around here, so I can congratulate you more properly. Please sit down.
Thank you,
you
sir.
You have chosen well for yourself, Bruce Lee. Krishnamurti. All right, class. Is there anyone among you who is familiar with this biography? Anybody? Bruce Lee, why don't you tell us something about Krishnamurti?
Krishnamurti was born on May 12, 1895.
Just discuss it sitting down.
He was born with the ability to communicate with God. At 14, he was chosen as the Messiah by the Institute. And after he was enlightened, in 1925, in order to ensure the church's independence and innocence, he left the Institute and started his 50-year journey of preaching to others.
Very good. How did you come to know so much about him?
Well, I just read the book called The Journey of Spirit, sir.
Thank you, Bruce. That's correct. Krishnamurti's philosophy can be quite interesting. Lately, there are people who would say that philosophy has already reached its end. It has come to its end, and others would even say that philosophy is dead. Maybe it's worth finding out why philosophers of today are starting to find the world less interesting than it was before. As for you, young philosophers, ask yourselves the usual questions like, who are you? What's your purpose in this world? And how will you go about it? These are the important questions that you should ask yourself and learn from the philosophers. Krishnamurti said something enlightening in the book that Bruce had mentioned. He told his followers, I have taught you only one thing, to observe yourselves, to discover yourselves, and to surpass yourselves.
Yeah.